Hello automators, thanks for tuning in again. Now, one of the best ways to improve your smart home significantly is with sensors. I mean, if you can't sense a trigger, then you can't automate off of it. And so what I'm going to do today is take you through number one, the different sensors that are on this device. Then I'm going to show you how those different sensors allowed me to set up some very, very complex automations and utilize a lot of the sensors on board. So this Aeotec Multisensor 6, it has a number of different sensors on it. Now, when you compare it to a Samsung SmartThings sensor, well, this has a motion sensor and a temperature sensor. So it is capable of both of those things, but so is the Aeotec. It has a motion sensor on it, and it also has a temperature sensor. Now, the temperature sensor has a slight upgrade when you're working with it in a system like Samsung SmartThings. It has a tenth of a degree capability here in Celsius. So it's able to measure and therefore tighten up your automations on temperature a lot more versus this. Now, this is where the similarities really start and end. There's really nothing more to talk about with this device. That's what it is. You can deploy it, and it's a fairly nice motion sensor. It does a really good job in my home in a lot of ways. But what this has is a humidity sensor on it, and that's a big benefit, obviously, in a lot of different spaces. So you can get what's called the relative humidity and then create automations out of that. You can also use the lux or illuminant sensor that's on this, and that's a pretty rare thing to find in terms of sensors these days. And what that allows you to do is really, and this is the way I used it immediately on getting this, is really adjust how your lighting is performing. Now, there's also a UV light sensor, which is obviously, you know, in a number of different ways, a bit of a safety thing that you can utilize and have automations trigger off of. There's also a tamper sensor. So as I move this around, the tamper sensor is going off, and that means I can use it a lot like a security device or a lot like a multi-purpose sensor. Now, coupled with all of this is the way you power the device, and this is something my father's always asking me for, so I'm probably gonna have to buy him a couple of these. Thanks, Dad. But anyways, the Aeotec here, it has a dual powering capability. So number one, you're gonna get a couple of years of battery life out of this device when you put in two of the batteries here. Now, after that, if you wanna power it forever, it comes with its own supplied USB cable, and it's a ribbon cable that comes out of the bottom and allows you to plug that USB cable into any USB port, and therefore your device will remain powered. So you have this dual power option with this device that you just don't have with a lot of other sensors. Now, honestly, if you're not already sold on this upgrade, well, okay, let me tell you a few more things. The sensitivity of the motion sensor here can be adjusted in the Samsung SmartThings Classic application. I'm sure that'll come across to the new application as well, but right now you can adjust the sensitivity and you can also adjust delay. So if you don't want something to necessarily trigger immediately, you can actually stick a delay on this device, and that will allow you to sense time, make sure you're sensing time over a number of seconds or even minutes. Not only that, but you can have these sensors report more often than the hour interval that's there. So you can adjust this all the way down to 8 minutes natively in the Samsung SmartThings Classic app again. And there are even scripts out there and things that you can go and implement that will allow it to report even faster if you'd like. Now, just to keep in mind there, I want to clarify one thing. That doesn't mean the motion sensor is only going to report every 8 minutes. That's an interrupt policy item. So, you know, tamper and motion, those things are reported immediately. It's these other sensors, the humidity, the lux, the UV light, that are reporting every so often, and only if there's a significant change. So it's all well and good to have all of these sensors, but if you don't use them, well, then what was the point in spending the money? Now, here's what I instantly did with this device. My lighting in the bathroom, I mean, I have a lot of lights in that bathroom, and actually in total, it's 9. Now, that means I can really overwhelm someone with the lighting. And with this, all I could do was basically set a time of day and then have the lights turn on to a certain percentage. Well, you know, that's great. It allows you to keep them relatively dark in the evenings, and that's, you know, that's pretty powerful. But then during the day, well, I have a window in my bathroom, so I don't necessarily need all of the light all the time, and you won't necessarily need all the light all the time in your space. Now, what this allows me to do is, based off of the lux or the illuminance sensor, I've actually set different thresholds to brighten the lights to 10, 30, and 50%. And of course, I can turn them on to 100%. That makes the illuminance really positive in terms of setting up a more consistent lighting situation in my home. I also instantly used all of the new sensors on my action tiles display, which I have a video out about here that I will leave down in the comments below or in the description below. Now, on top of that, the UV sensor, like I said, it's a bit of a safety thing. And so what you can do with that is instantly change the color of a bulb in your home to let you know that you have an issue. So if you're ever experiencing that kind of light, you don't want that kind of light in your home, well, that makes sense. Go ahead and use a bulb trigger, a color change, along with, say, Philips Hue attached to SmartThings like I did. And there's more you can do here. Because of the humidity sensor here, I don't have these kinds of fans. We have a humidity balancing system in the home. So they just automatically sense the humidity in the room and start balancing it throughout the house. But if you had a fan in your home, you could put a smart switch in there that's able to drive the fan motor, and then you're able to use that humidity to turn on and off a fan light. And what I will do going forward is I'll be buying another one of these for my garage. I'll talk to you about what I can continue to do in terms of refining the lighting level. And I know I'm going to do this, I just haven't done it yet. WebCore is a significant system for developing further automation. And what I want to do is actually set up a formulaic response here for that lux to the lighting. And I'm thinking like something like whatever the lux or the illumination level is, 100 minus that, and then some kind of dividing factor to bring up the lights and to have that consistently running and changing as this illumination sensor updates. In any case, I think there's a ton of reason to go out and upgrade from one of these to one of these, especially if you're using Samsung SmartThings or a number of the other Z-Wave hubs, because it's a little Z-Wave device. Now, what I'm going to do here is I'm going to post my log of utilizing this device in our community forums. And so if you ever want to see this, there'll be a link down below, and I will continue to update that log as I continue to update the automation on this device. So you're going to be able to see the evolution of how I use it in my smart home. So that link is down below. And otherwise, guys, you can go ahead and watch our Samsung SmartThings automation series here. There's a number of different videos in this playlist that's on screen right now that will help you utilize Samsung SmartThings in your smart home. So until next time, guys, don't hate, automate.